Welcome back to my channel. This is your girl Gwen. Please, if you're new to this channel, kindly subscribe down below and don't forget to give your girl a thumbs up. Please like this video, share, and put down your comments down the comment section of what you think. Thank you to my old subscribers, my new subscribers. Thank you, and welcome to this family. And also my viewers, thank you for viewing my video. Do you yet to subscribe? And we are expecting you guys on board. The last video I did, yes, one of the videos I did was on how to mind your business. Please, sorry for the noise in the background. I don't know if you're hearing my baby's voice, she's shouting. So, yeah, she's playing, so she shouts while she's playing. Okay, so last video I did was on how to mind your business. And in this video, I'm going to be having a Q&A on how to mind your business. You can benefit from it. Just listen and know where you're falling and get an advice. Of course, I sought for this advice various places and I put them together to be able to relate this information to you guys. And number one, amongst this question says, how can I distance myself from my roommate's private life if we share a room? I don't know. So let me see the answer. Listen to music. See, if you're listening to music, focus on your studies and work. Wear earphones when they have private conversation. Wearing earplugs at night may be helpful if noise is an issue at night. And purchasing an eye mask can also help if lightning is a concern. Make sure to refrain from going through their stuff as well. Do your best to be conscious and respect their privacy. This one is a serious problem. How do you mind your business when you have a roommate? We can see the reply. You can see the answer. Community answer. So, like I said, put your comment down the comment section. Are you agreeing to this or are you disagreeing? Are you with us or are you against us? Okay, the next one says, why do people feel to need to get involved in other people's business? Some people feel it's their right to get into your business. Some people feel it's their right to talk about you. Some people feel it's their right to discuss you. Yes, I know some people are so kind. They want to always put in their mouth in everything that concerns every individual. Some are not in a negative way. They always like to support. They always like to run, of course, render help. And some people don't like it. So you should be able to know people around you, understand them, read their body movement. If they like you to put your mouth in their problem, if they don't like you putting your mouth in their problem, then you stay off. You stay totally off. And this one said, how can I politely stop someone from meddling in my personal affair? In my last video concerning on how to mind the business, one of the tips in minding your business is you should be able to tell the person to butt out. And I'm like, but telling the person categorically to butt out sounds very rude. I don't know what this person said. Okay, yeah, this person went towards what I said in that video. This person said, just say, don't worry about it, I can handle it, and change the topic. In my video, I said, don't worry about it, I can handle it. Yes, and this is exactly what the community answer gave me concerning this, which makes me be on the right path. Okay, the next question is, what do you do when you are naturally nosy? What do you do when you put mouth nosy into everything? Into everything. You know, there's something that came up before. When why do people feel need to get involved into other person's business? It's different from being nosy. Nosy, usually, for me, in my own understanding, feeling the need to get involved sounds more kind. The person doesn't necessarily be a meddler or a gossip or someone that likes to do a proku when the person feels the need to get involved. But this one that says when you're naturally nosy. I want a face grade gossip. Well, the answer says, just because you're prone to a behavior does not mean that you can't alter it or that you're not responsible for how it affects others. If you realize that being nosy is ultimately hurting your relationship with others or causing you unnecessary stress, it's time to consciously try to change your ways. If it's affecting others, then you have to change. Don't always say you don't care or you care whether it affects anybody or not. Set example. You want to show that you won't participate in damaging gossip, but you also don't want to seem self-righteous about it. The solution is to be a leader through your action and behavior, not through lecturing or being dogmatic. If you're having trouble staying away from gossip, start small. Challenge yourself to not participate for a full day. If you succeed, extend the length to your next challenge until it becomes a habit rather than a challenge. And this one here says, this other question here says, I have tried these things, but they don't work. And this one is basically 10 years old, and he or she's already concerned about he or she, maybe how he or she meddles in people's business. He or she has still seen it as a problem. Yeah. This one even tried, 10 years old, but he or she's already recognizing what is wrong about meddling in people's business, not minding your business. And they told the person, learning to mind your business takes time. Start by setting yourself a small goal, such as walking away from one private conversation that you really want to butt in. Once you have done that, keep building up to a bigger challenges. Minding your own business doesn't mean you need to stop talking. It's just that you need to be mindful of when and how you're talking. I think this advice is just perfect for this 10 years old boy or girl. I don't know, the gender wasn't specified, but I think this reply is just perfect. Yes, you have to, like I said in my last video, if you're in an environment outside of your home, they're discussing about somebody you know, or they're talking about something that doesn't interest you, that sounds to you like a gossip, or sounds like they're meddling in people's business, you can just walk away. I said this in my last video. You can just walk away. You can just say, I'm coming, I need to pick up something, I need to drop something, I need to go and fetch something. Just say one thing and just leave that environment. And I said in that last video that if this discussion is happening in your house, you can always change the topic. You have the right to change the topic. It's happening in your house because, mind you, if anything comes out of it, even if you didn't say anything, it happened in your house. Nobody's going to believe that you said nothing when it was happening in your house. Come on, so long as it's in your house that the whole situation happened, you're number one culprit. So if you want to avoid being number one culprit and avoid everything that concerns it, what you just have to do is to tell them to change the topic, or you bring up something else, or you tell them, please, I don't like this discussion in my house. I think it's too serious. Can we change topic? And just said it here. And minding your business does not mean you should stop talking to people. I said in my last video that minding your business does not mean you should not render help to people that need help, or you have a situation that you're only person around that particular place in the particular point in time, then you say you're not meddling because you want to mind your business, or a minor accident occurred, you're supposed to assist. Maybe the person is a little bit unconscious, you're supposed to assist, then you're going straight or walking straight away and saying it's not your business. No, it doesn't mean you should stop talking to people. just means, mind your business just means you should be mindful of when and how you are talking. Yes, some people are just very crazy with the way they talk. They don't care. Some people don't care in a positive way. They just say it the way it is. It is better. Yeah, that one is a different thing. But the one I'm saying is like, you just talk about someone. You don't care the way it comes out, like how hot food comes out from your mouth. It's not just nice. And the other one says, what do you do when you don't want someone's sympathy? I think you don't have to tell your story. It's best to be polite but direct. Tell them that you appreciate their concern but would prefer if they did not say anything further about the situation. Well, that is your opinion. In my own opinion, I would say if you don't want someone's sympathy, then you have to act strong in front of the person. You don't want someone's sympathy and your face is all moody and you all look like someone that's... I think my baby's voice is so loud. She's playing, she's just shouting. That's her own way of playing. Shout and shout the whole house. She's upstairs, I'm here, and she's shouting the whole house and everything. But please, I hope it's not affecting you guys. As I was saying, yes, tell them that you appreciate their concern and you prefer to handle this yourself. But me, if you don't want sympathy, then you have to put up a smiling face and act strong all through the time and always. And the next question says, how do you know the difference between informing someone of something important and personal? Yes, this one is also very, very cool. I love this question that just came up. How do you know the difference between informing someone of something important and butting in? Yes, because you can be telling someone something important and the person might think you're overstepping your boundary. For me, I think once you just start to say that thing that is important that you think in your own understanding is not butting in, and trust me, once you start talking and the person sees you're about to say something and is not interested, you should be able to read the body movement. Body movement says a lot. Where I was working, you don't even need to talk. Then the customer tells you your body movement or your body reaction it says otherwise. You didn't say anything. Because people can read body movement very well. And that is, when you inform someone about something important, it should not be such that it turns the person to whom you inform against the person. Who did something? Okay? It may start a fight between them and they may later blame you for butting in. Typical example is boyfriend and girlfriend. Now they are pulling out. They're not using a reconcile. Or friend and friend. You know, two best friends, either a guy or a girl, mustn't be opposite sex, the same sex. You're not gonna pull me out to say something because you feel it's important. At the end of the day, they use and reconcile because he or she is more closer to the person that you're relating with. So you're the third party. So at the end of the day, they will reconcile. You being the third party, you still kukuma day. Okay, guys, these are the questions and the answer, and I hope you guys were able to hear me loud. I hope few of you or lots of you that are going to listen to this video will be able to pick the side that you feel that you need to work on, or we need to work on. Probably if nothing in this situation affects you, then you're fine. I know I can sometimes be too kind that I will always want to attend to you and all, and of course I've not been in a situation that I know of that you can read it wrongly or something like that. Yes, because it was mentioned here that what if you're in a situation where you always feel like to assist someone, which is almost very normal with every few human beings that likes to give empathy. Yes, so of course, we're not able to differentiate that most of the time. So guys, thank you. If you have any of your addition in this question and answer, or you have want to ask any question concerning minding your business, you can put it down in the comment section and we'll discuss about it. But these are the few questions that I was able to gather that are important, that I feel that will impact us in one way or the other, that are important. That is why I gathered them up and decided to share it. Like I probably put the one of 10 years old boy, the gender wasn't mentioned, 10 years old, that at early stage identified that he or she has been meddling in people's problem. That's 10 years old. So, but he or she has already understood that it looks like I put my mouth in things that concern me, that doesn't concern me. It looks like I talk a lot, and how do I stop it? So identifying your problem very early is a plus one. Yes. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for listening to this video. Please don't forget to subscribe down below so you can get my videos every Mondays, Wednesdays, and Friday. Please give this video a thumbs up, like, and share. And thank you again. Do have a great day. Bye.